Hey everyone, it's Hirsch Wilson, and today is, I'm pretty sure it's Wednesday, June 24th. I hope you're well, and I hope you're keeping it together. This year just gets stranger and stranger. Now we have a dust storm, a sandstorm blowing in from the Sahara Desert, and there are locust swarms in Africa. So weirder and weirder. One of my favorite writers, Annie Lamont, wrote that you should never think or say that the worst is over, because that will call down the evil eye so fast it'll leave you keening. So there's that. I want to continue a conversation about how we can stay emotionally healthy through all of this. I thought about how I've been feeling the last couple of weeks, and I recognized that they were actually a familiar set of feelings. Let me explain what I mean. They reminded me of how I feel or I have felt after a really bad call on the fire department. Often after a terrible call, I'd wander on for days. I'd be sad, I'd be angry, I'd be distracted. I just had no ability to focus or control my thinking. But over the years, and dozens and dozens of those kinds of calls, I've learned some techniques, some habits that kind of help me recover and get through the day. So first, I've learned to keep things really simple. The days after, or even the weeks after a really bad call, I kind of strip everything down to the bare essentials, to my priorities, which are my family, my work, and exercise. I think the next thing that I've learned to do is to forgive myself if I'm not accomplishing everything I want to accomplish. And I think that's an important message for us now. After all, we're in a unique situation. We have the pandemic, we're in the middle of that, we have this economic whatever it is, and we have this renewed and huge cry for racial justice. So that's a lot to take on. So we need to realize that even though we might have had time at home, it's okay that we haven't written the great American novel or rebuilt the deck around our house. It's okay, and we need to forgive ourselves. A lot going on, we're very distracted. There's just an overwhelming amount of information. So don't beat yourself up if you're not getting stuff done. I think the final thing is probably the most important, and it is this. I've learned to say to myself, sometimes daily, sometimes hourly, that this too shall pass. I remember once after a really bad call, we were sitting in the fire department group and the next day debriefing the call and checking in on how everybody was doing. And a paramedic stood up and said, you know, the next few months are going to suck. And he was right. And there's two parts to that message. The first part is, yes, it's going to be hard. We're going to have sleepless nights. We're going to worry a lot. There'll be a lot of stress and a lot of distraction. But the other part of the message was, it's not forever. We'll get through this. It will pass. And I think that's what firefighters learn, is that even after some of the most horrific calls, the feeling goes away after a while. It takes time, but it goes away. So that's kind of the message for today. So remember, don't say, don't think that the worst is over, and I'll see you next week. So be brave, be kind, follow the science.